Help us to be humble. Teach us how to pray. Show us how to seek you and turn from our old ways. See, the world is in a crisis. We don't know what to do, but you're our only option. God, we're crying out to you. Won't you open your eyes, Lord, and hear our hearts cry. Hear us and heal us. Heal us. Heal our land. Heal us like only you can. Lord, heal us. Heal our land. Heal us like only you can. Lord, heal us. See, Father, we are troubled. We need a safe place. Our hearts are overwhelmed. We need to see your face. We've made some bad decisions. We don't know what to do, but you're our only option. And God, we're crying out to you. Open your eyes, Lord. Won't you hear our hearts cry? Hear us and heal us. Heal us. Won't you heal our land? This is our prayer. Like only you can. Oh, God.
Recently been praying a lot, 'cause I've been moving a lot, making decisions a lot, living a lot without you.
Trying to get back to the truth, yeah,
that I'm nothing without you. So I lift my hands and surrender to you, 'cause through you everything is meaning. I'm all to see more of you and less of me with everything that I'm doing. I'm coming to your throne room, giving you all praise and glory, asking you to forgive me and reignite my calling. Make every move I make
blossom flowers,
and every word I say
plenty.
'Cause you are everything, the only thing I need.
recently been praying a lot. 'Cause I've been moving a lot, making decisions a lot, living a lot without you. Trying to get back to the truth that I'm nothing without you. So I lift my hands and surrender to you. 'Cause through you everything has meaning. I want them all to see more of you and less of me with everything that I'm doing. Oh, I come into your throne room giving you all praise and glory. Hey, asking you to forgive me and reignite my calling. May every move I make and every word I say, oh, 'cause you are everything, the only thing we need.
May your will lead the way. Oh, I won't stand in your way. Where you say go, I will go. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Now I open my senses to you,
to you,
to receive everything you are. Use me, Lord, I dedicate this heart.
Newark, New Jersey, good evening, good evening, good evening, and welcome to the 2020 Lincoln Park Music Festival. This is a celebration of spirit. I am the Reverend Elder Kevin E. Taylor, Senior Pastor of Unity Fellowship Church, Newark, right here in downtown Newark, New Jersey. And before we do anything else, let's have a word of prayer. Gracious and eternal Lord God, we come before you tonight to say thank you. We thank you that in the midst of it all, you have given us this opportunity to come together, to be together, to celebrate, to elevate, to praise, and to worship. We thank you, Lord God, that you will cover every corner of Newark, of New Jersey, and everyone around the world who has come to this space looking for grace, looking for peace, looking for just a few hours to be still and know that in the midst of it all, you are with us, keeping, covering, and comforting us in the midst of it all. We thank you. We thank you for the organizers. We thank you for the artists. We thank you for the space and the grace. Now tonight, let us in our living rooms, in our bedrooms, in our offices, if we are sitting on the balcony watching this on our phones, let us be willing to turn wherever we are into our tabernacle, that we might have sanctuary around us and have the sanctity of space to know that all is well. Bless us, and we are blessed. Keep us, and we're kept. And for this and all the things you do so well, for this and this week and this pandemic that you've gotten us through and this journey that we are on right now to a higher level of consciousness, of grace, of mercy, of peace, and power, we say thank you. And that is why without one doubt, while we scream and we shout, that we keep on trusting, for your word is true. You've already done what you said you would do. We declare ashe and amen, and so it is. So Newark, New Jersey, let's say thank you and God bless you. To Brother Ian Johnson for that wonderful song, Heal the Land. And to Brother A. Natural. And to Brother Lenny Harold for The Only Thing We Need. What a beautiful way to start off this music festival, this virtual celebration of spirit. And when we heard those wonderful and empowering titles, one song came to mind from a Newark, a New Jersey, a music giant who decades ago reminded us that what the world needs now. And when we were able to get Ms. Warwick to say yes to allowing this celebration song to go forward tonight, we decided we wanted to pay tribute to her because Dionne Warwick is an icon, a legend, and an institution to Newark, New Jersey. She, along with her family members, were the Drinkards in the 50s, and they were a solid rock foundation to gospel music right here in Newark. And then she stepped out on her own, being what very few had ever thought possible, a pop superstar in her skin in the 60s with 40 top 10 hits, including What's It All About, Alfie, and Then Came You, and I Know I Never Loved This Way Again, and Do You Know the Way to San Jose, and she's Dionne Warwick. So we decided that we were going to ask one of our own pantheons of power, praise, and worship to sing in tribute to her. So we went to Susu Mobian, and I'm telling you, very few people can sing as solidly and sure-footedly as that gospel titan, as that house music powerhouse. So Susu Bobby is going to come forward in tribute to Dionne Warwick and the Drinkards. Then she's going to do one of her own selections. And then, stilling us as we move forward, will be Miss Warwick herself with a song that has brought peace to the land, a song that she has re-released as she has recorded many of her hits over again, and a song that is speaking peace, as people have said, this is the song that I needed for such a time as this. So up first, Susu Bobian, in tribute to the astonishing, astounding Miss Dionne Warwick, as Susu comes in her own way, and immediately thereafter, the icon, the institution that is Dionne Warwick herself. Let them come forward. Get ready for some good down music. Let's go. Susu Bobian is about to tear this place up and show you how it's supposed to be done. Susu Bobian, let's go.
To Linkin Park Virtual Festival. Once again, I welcome you into my world, Susu Bobian's world of joy, happiness, and peace and love that I bring to you, the world, to inspire, to uplift, to encourage, to be enthused, to be motivated with whatever you are trying to pursue in life. May God bless you all in your endeavors. Please stand by, listen, and enjoy. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder, soldiers of the cross. Every rung goes higher, every rung goes higher and higher. Every rung goes higher and higher. Soldiers of the cross. Rise, shine, give God the glory. Rise, shine, give God the glory. Rise, shine. Give God the glory.
the cross. Keep on climbing. We will, make it. Keep on climbing.
In a peaceful state of mind during the pandemic. And then listening to Mayor Raz with him telling us to be still. And then hearing the voice of God, being still, knowing that I am God, waiting on the Lord. To see the salvation of the Lord. This was a process of elimination for me. It humbled me. So I just wanna just share a little bit with my friends, fans, loved ones, family. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be He shall renew. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Thy strength. Wait, I say, on the Lord, He shall renew, ooh, thy strength. Sometimes troubles will come, and even sometimes strong winds will blow, but that God is by my side, by my side, by my side, by my side.
What the world is now is love, sweet love.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Dionne Warwick.
It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Oh, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb, and there are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Though not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. And there are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine. Won't you listen, Lord, if you want to know.
Good evening, good evening, good evening, good evening, good evening. I am so excited tonight regarding is wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. 14.2, oh my God, edition of the Linkin Park Music Festival with my co-host, Pastor Kevin Taylor. I thank God for Anthony Smith and his team who thought it not robbery for us to go forward to make sure that those of you out there watching Facebook or whatever room you're sitting in, wherever you are, tuned in, call a friend, text, tag, and tell that you are visiting, you have joined the Linkin Park Virtual Global Soul Gospel Celebration Spirit. Come on and let's pray. Dear God, we come before your throne of grace on this evening. The song led us off with Heal the Land. In 2 Chronicles 7:14, you see, if those people who are called by my name will humble themselves and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. And Lord, you promised that you would heal the land if we would just do what you said, do, God. And that's turn from our wicked ways, God, and seek your face. So tonight, as we come before you virtually, we're seeking your face. We're seeking to be in your presence. We're thanking you for all of the artists. We thank God for our sister, our beloved Dionne Warwick, who reminded us that, Lord, what the world needs now is love, sweet love. We thank you for Sister Susu, who reminded us that in the book of Psalms, it tells us to be still and know that you are God. So as we come before your throne of grace on tonight, we thank you, God, for a leader for the city of Newark called Mayor Raz Baraka. We thank you for a young man called Anthony Smith that years ago decided that he would step out on faith and reach the masses through music and through arts and through culture. We thank you, oh God, that the team that works with us, God, they do what they need to do and do their due diligence to do things decent and in order. So God, as I come before you, even in the midst of a pandemic, I pray that you help us to help each other to be safe. I pray that you help us to have a spirit of obedience, to know that we've got to look out for one another. Lord, the greatest commandment is that we love one another. Whether we like each other or not, God, help us to love one another. Help us to care for one another. Help us to be keepers of one another, because God, you are the best keeper. So we thank you right now for being a keeper. We thank you right now for being a lover to us. We thank you right now for keeping your arms of protection around us. We pray for our city right now. We pray for our state right now. We pray for our country right now. We pray for this world right now, because as the song says, you got the whole world in your hands. So since the whole world is in your hands, we're in the best of hands. You also said the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof and all that dwell therein. So since we are the all, we pray that all of these events from now until next week for Linkin Park, it's in your hands. Our health is in your hands. Our family is in your hands. All is in your hands. So since we're part of the all, God, we come to give you thanks. We come to give you glory. And we come to give you praise. So God, please, please hear this, your humble servant's prayer. No matter what the denomination, no matter what the faith, no matter who it is, God, that's coming before your throne of grace, we come with a heart of thanksgiving, saying, God, continue to see us through these seasons. Now we pray, God, that you continue to be in us, to strengthen us as we go forward. Be beneath us, to support us, God, because you uphold us on every side. Please, God, keep angels encamped over us as a shelter, as our ancestors have already paved the way. Continue, God, to be with us no matter what, because you said in your word you would never leave or forsake us. So on this weekend and the weekend to come, we pray for nothing but the best, because God, you are a good God, and we know that every good and perfect gift comes from you. So God, we thank you for the gift of this evening. We thank you for the gift of life. Please hear this, your humble servant's prayer, in the name of some who call Jesus, in the name of some who call Allah, in the name of some who call Elohim, and in the name of some who call Yahweh. But you are our God and our creator, and we give you thanks. Amen, amen, and ashe. And now, with all of that said and done, we are in for an awesome, awesome treat. We've been blessed up until this point with some great artists. And it's not over. We're going to continue to be blessed with more, more awesome performances. The next performance that you're going to see will be that of a New Jersey native called Carl Brister. And then there's going to be another blessing from a brother called Charles Jerkins. And then we're going to get this message of hope from one of North's pastors who's full of love, full of hope, and full of the word, and always having an encouraging spirit, pastoring right here in the city of Newark in Lincoln Park, the True Vine Church, none other than Apostle Roberto Comasanas. But before all of that, let's get ready, let's tune in, and let's hear the call register.
How can we call this the land of the free if you're talking about everybody else but me? And how can my kids begin to unsee or unhear the words from a man on TV who died under the officer's knee? Enough is enough.
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 I can't breathe. Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Bodies have to fall. How many slurs do we have to be called before we end systematic racism once and for all? Because united we'll stand, and divided we'll fall. We'll stand up for justice or we'll tear down the wall. You'll never truly make America great until Black Lives Matter.
Enough. is enough.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching.
You can see that the world is coming to an end. Yet there's still so many people dying in their sins. God has chosen me and you to let them know that they can have everlasting life. Free their souls, help them out, show the love,
Jesus,
and help them. If you see a brother going through many problems he don't understand, and you're there with all the strength inside that you can share, you can help him with some words of encouragement. Then you'll see a smile come on his face, 'cause somebody cares. Help them out. Help them out. Show the love of Jesus. And help them out. Help them out. Show the love of Jesus. Show the love of Jesus. Oh, 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 oh. Help them out. Show the love of Jesus. Yeah, yeah. Show the love of Jesus. If you see a mother crying because her son is dying, and she doesn't know which way that she should turn, you can let her know that everything would be all right if she would trust the Lord Jesus Christ. Help them out. Oh, help them out. Oh Lord, all races, all denominations.
denominations. Show the love of Jesus. That's what God called us to do. Oh, yeah. Help them out. Somebody come on and help them out. Pour out your bowels of compassion unto your brother and unto your friend. Help them out, yeah. Oh, Lord. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh. God's been good. God's been good to us. We got to help them out. Somebody may need shoes on their feet, clothes on their back, food on the table. Yeah. I'm telling you that God is able. Help them out, somebody. Somebody laying in the hospital room. We got to help them out. Go read the word to them. Go lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Help them out. These are the last days. Men and women need to be saved. There's your daughter. There's your son. Dying out here in a world of sin. We gotta show the love of Jesus and help them out. Come on, somebody. Come on. Help them out. I know you can do it. I know you can do it. Do it now. Do it today. Help somebody.
Bendice, alma mía, a Jehová. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget, don't ever, under any circumstances, forget any of his benefits. There is a benefit in serving and believing the Lord. Praise God. I am Apostle Roberto Comezanas, and I have been granted the privilege, the honor of addressing you this precious event with a word and a thought and a blessing. I am the pastor. If you're at Lincoln Park right now, physically, which I doubt, but if you are, or the next time that you're there, in the corner of Lincoln Park and Halsey Street, there is a great, magnificent Gothic cathedral, which we have christened the Newark Cathedral. That is the temple in which the church, La Vid Verdadera, the true vine, is housed. The temple at this moment is closed because of the pandemic and the quarantine and et cetera, et cetera. But the church is alive and well and flourishing through social media. The church is not closed, only the temples. Because the church is not the building. The church is us, the people, the believers, the family of faith. So here we are, alive and well, celebrating Gospel Night at the Music Festival. I want to thank God for allowing me to be here representing him. I want to thank our mayor, Ras Baraka, whom I consider my brother in Christ. I want to thank Reverend Roundtree and all the ministers that were involved in choosing me. I want to thank the Lincoln Park Spiritual Health Overseers. I just gave you a new title, Anthony and crew. You know who you are. Listen to this title. I think you're going to like it. You are the Lincoln Park Spiritual Health Overseers. You oversee over the spiritual health of our community, and I am grateful for your life. Thank you again for allowing me to be here. Que Dios los bendiga a todos. May God bless all of you. I want to talk to you today. I'm going to try to be brief and to the point. I don't want to bore you. And besides, we're in a party. This is not church. I know this is not a church pulpit. This is a city pulpit. So my message is not a congregational message. It's a message to the people of the city of Newark, to the people of the United States, to the children of God, whichever way you may identify God, I am going to speak as a Christian. I am a Bible-believing, born-again Christian, and I am going to speak from that position. Feel free to accept or reject what you need to accept or reject. Amen? Thank you. The times we're living, who would have thought it that we will have a Lincoln Park Festival virtual? We could not be there physically, regardless of weather, because we're in the middle of a pandemonium. Yeah, look it up and Google it later. Some of you call it a pandemic, I call it a pandemonium. It's an insane situation, an insane moment in time that we're all living. These are the times that we are living. As a Christian, I am in awe because the things that we have been preaching for years are now being manifest before our eyes. Every time I turn on the TV set and watch the news, I see prophecy being fulfilled. For years, we've been saying Jesus Christ is coming back. The end is near. Well, I don't want to go into a whole thesis about the subject. The coming of Jesus is in segments. And the first part, which we're living now, is signs of his coming. We see the climatic changes. We see the changes in our politics. We see the changes in the behavior of our society. We see sicknesses and hunger and catastrophes all over the place. It's as if the earth itself was telling us that we need to get right with God because we are at a climatic moment in the history of mankind. The Apostle Peter in 1 Peter chapter 4, 7 to 9 says this, and I quote, "But the end of all things is at hand. The end of all things is at hand. Therefore, be serious and watchful in your prayers. And above all things, have fervent love for one another. For love will cover a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without grumbling." It's interesting that when you study the life of the apostles, in the beginning of their ministry, they were very gung-ho, Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost and fire, repent, turn or burn. Their preaching was like very radical about the changing the lifestyles of the pagans. Towards the end of their ministry, their main subject, when they matured in Christianity, the main subject, when they understood what the world really needed, their main subject is love. Love one another. Love God. Be kind. Be forgiving. Be giving. Love the person next to you, whether he or she wants to be loved or not. Love even those who are cursing at you and persecuting you. Because at the end of all, at the end of all things, all that matters is whether you loved and loved and loved even those who didn't deserve to be loved, even those who didn't want to be loved, even those who hated you. Because if you love them, you won. Their hatred didn't enter you. You remain in love regardless of what they do. That's what Jesus meant when he said, if they turn, hit you one cheek, turn the other cheek. He wasn't talking about not defending yourself. He was talking about not allowing their hatred, their prejudice, their ignorance to enter your spirit. Your spirit, my heart belongs to the Lord. And God is love. So I'm not going to allow what's happening around me to rob me of the love that I know that God has for me and that I have for him. And because I live in the love of God, I will love you also, whether you want me to or not. I will love you because my heart belongs to God and God is love. Wow, this is like a children's Bible study, but it's the most profound teaching in the Bible to love. The end of the matter all have been heard. Love God and keep his commandments. And what are his commandments? That you will love the Lord your God with all of your heart, all of your mind, and all of your soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. The fulfillment of the law is love. So don't let the hatred, the ignorance, the prejudice that's out there enter your heart. Keep your posture, fight for your rights, but do it out of love for yourself, love for your fellow man, love for justice, love for righteousness, love for your country. Let love be your king. Let love be your guide. Don't let hatred ever enter your mind, your heart, or your soul. Stay within the perimeter of the blessings of God. Be a vessel for his presence and for his mercy and for his love. Praise God. I hope you're getting this. In the signs of his coming, Matthew chapter 24, and again, I'm not going to elaborate because this is not the place of the time. One of the signs of his coming, which really hurts me when I see it on TV, I see it in the news all the time, I see it in the media, I see it in the political arena more than anything. I see it in what's happening in our social interactions. One of the signs, Jesus said, because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. And we see that. I see that in the pulpit even. You cannot be a Christian if you lack love, because the center of Christianity is that God so loved the world that he sent his only son, not to die for the righteous and not to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. The center of our preaching is God. God is love, and he manifested his love by giving us his son, that we may be forgiven from our sins. So in this age of lawlessness, and please listen to that word, lawlessness, there is no longer law. When you go against the law, whether you are the mailman, the policeman, the fireman, whether you are the guy at the supermarket or the bodega, or you're in a high seat of government, if you don't have love, then you are in lawlessness. If you don't have law, you will disobey the laws that even you yourself have made. That is the epitaph of hypocrisy, that law makers are law breakers. But even if that's what's happening in their world, because I am in the world but not of the world, I am of the kingdom, their lawlessness cannot take me away from the law of God. And the fulfillment of the law is that I will love my neighbor as I love myself. I will do unto you as I would like you to do unto me. The verse that we read in 2 Peter says that above all things be fervent in prayer, and love for one another and be hospitable to one another without grumbling. This is where I get this about, I'm going to love you whether you want to be loved or not, because I'm not going to allow your racism, your prejudice, your ignorance, your hatred, your bitterness, whatever happened to you in your past, that cannot taint me. What could happen is that the love that God has poured upon my heart, the peace, the joy that surpasses understanding, might change your heart and bring you into a world of forgiveness. Listen, I don't know who you are, and I don't know what you're going through. This pandemic and this quarantine has hit us all differently. One thing it has done, it has revealed things to you about yourself that you didn't know. Now that you're in quarantine, now that you're with yourself or with your family, and you really can't go out, you are forced to look inward, to look at where you live, at your situation, at your life, to reevaluate your spiritual life. And I don't know whether you're a proud boy or a proud girl, but my advice is not for you to stand by or stand back, but to get on your knees and repent from your sins and seek the Lord while he might yet be found. These are the times we are living. This is only the first pandemic. There are others that are coming. The Bible says so. Hurricanes, tornadoes, earthquakes, pestilence, hunger, riots in the streets, whether they're justified or not, are in the Bible. This age of lawlessness will produce more lovelessness within society. What it cannot do, if you don't allow it, is it cannot rob you of the peace of God, the faith in God, your hope in God, and your love. Don't allow it to do that. Keep your heart. Above all things guarded, guard your heart, because from it issue the flows of life. I hope I translated that correctly. Praise God. I'm about to close. Romans 13 says, owe no one anything except to love one another, for he who loves his neighbor has fulfilled the law. Because love does no wrong to a neighbor, therefore love is the fulfilling of the law. These times that we are living, and I spoke about love, and I spoke about not letting hatred come into your heart, I have a confession to make. I know it's going to shock some of you, so maybe you should sit down, those of you who know me, but I am a born-again, Bible-believing Christian.
So I'm Captain Jonathan Jackson, and I am the area coordinator for the Salvation Army of Newark. Behind me, you'll see our warehouse in full swing. Since the COVID virus hit, one of the first things we understood was there would be a great need for food for families.
And this is our response to serving our neighbors and our friends in Newark. What you see behind here is how we put together boxes, and each box consists of about 21 meals that could serve a family of two. If it's a family of four, we give them two boxes so that they could have a meal for about 10 days or so before they can come back and get some more. Since we've started, we've served over 150,000 meals. One of our most important partners throughout this process has also been the city of Newark. We've partnered with the Community Food Bank, United Way of Greater Newark, and also different agencies through that. So what we are doing here is we bag the food for all these different agencies that either deliver food to people, seniors and individuals who are shut in, or they distribute it at their own site.
We have a great staff here who have come together to provide food boxes for the community of Newark. We are trying to meet the need as best we can. And due to the need, not just in Newark, but also around in the northern New Jersey area, we've expanded this warehouse into be a regional warehouse where we're going to be able to distribute boxes to all the counties in the northern area. We have trucks that will be delivering them to the communities, and in hopes that we can meet the greater need.
Praise God. We want to thank all of our sponsors for this virtual celebration of spirit. We also want to take a moment to say thank you to all of our essential workers. What a tribute to the mass heroes of Newark, New Jersey, and people who are making sure that families who are in this journey are kept covered and comforted. So to all of our mass heroes, thank you very much. Now, here's what you came for. Listen. Here's what you came for. Listen. Here's what you came for. It's furniture moving time, because we're about to do a whole block of music that is going to give your soul everything it needs on this Friday evening. We're going to hear from Pastor Dale Cicerone and the Psalms of Praise as they tear the place up. We're going to hear from Queen Seychelle Elise, who is a daughter of mine who blessed us at our gala a few years ago as we paid tribute to Dionne Warwick in the city of Newark. And she's got a new album called Blessed, and she's right here from Newark, and her music blesses my soul. So she and her husband are coming forward. And then we're going to hear from Anthony Ponder and Ministries Desire APMD. And if you know what EPMD, they come in hard and holy. Hello, somebody. But up first, I'm proud to say, I'm like a proud papa. My choir, the Sounds of the New Ark, are coming forward to bless God in a magnificent and masterful way. So it's a whole block of music that's about to feed your soul. Tell somebody, as a good pastor, as a good Reverend Louise Roundtree from the Mayor's Office of Clergy Affairs just said, text, tag, and tell, because the Unity Fellowship Church Sounds of the New Ark Choir is up first, and then Pastor Dale Cicero and the Psalms of Praise, and then Queen Seychelle Elise, and then Anthony Ponder and Ministries Desire. I dare you to move some furniture and get ready to go higher, because the block is hot. You won't be seeing me and Rev Louise for about an hour, because this whole block is about to be hot, high, and holy. Lincoln Park, let's go! Ah.
You are worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You get the highest praise. Hallelujah.
You are holy.
You are holy. Lord, we exalt your name. Hallelujah. You are worthy. Hallelujah. You get the highest praise. Hallelujah.
Done great things
for you have done great.
you are my God. I'll forever praise your name. Sunshine in the morning, the moonlight at night. I'll forever praise, forever, never, never praise your name.
You are my God. Of the goodness of the Lord. I got Salvation. the Lincoln Park Music Festival. This is your girl, Seychelle Elise. And we virtual, but we still have fun, right? Hey. Today I'm going to do a couple songs with you, for you. This first one is Blessed. You might be a little bit familiar with it. Produced by my great husband, Khalil Folsom. Written by Mr. Rowan Khan and remixed by Intense and Derek Nelson. Hey. So if you can, dance with me a little bit. Enjoy this first one. And we're going to take you in worship for the next two. All right? Here we go. Mind focus, mouth open, hands raised, cause you know I gotta praise Him. It showed up a way into a new me state of mind. Shut down the pity party, cause I found a brand new day. Yeah, yeah. Told sadness, you best go home, cause round here you don't stand a chance. When you realize that He's blessed you, and there's nothing that can change it, you can't deny you feel special, cause the Lord showed you His favor with you, yeah. You've been blessed by Him, yeah. You can't deny you feel so, cause the Lord showed you His favor, yeah. Been around twice, had some good times. Always in the back of my mind, felt something just wasn't right. I was missing Him in my life. But now that I found that key, the puzzle of my restless heart is complete. Yeah, confusion's a retreat since I walked in holy clarity. It's so clear when you learn that He's blessed you, and there's nothing that can change it. No, you can't deny you feel special, cause the Lord, He showed you His favor, yeah. Showed you His favor, whoa. Yeah. Yes, He's blessed you. When you've been blessed, nothing can change. You can't deny you feel.
During this COVID season, we have felt like God's given up on us, but He hasn't. In this time, I hope you had time to reflect and look within and be silent and listen to what He's trying to show us. He would never, ever give up on us. In this piece, I have my accompaniment, my husband, my love, Mr. Khalil jamsy ideas pulsing. Enjoy. I hope that during this performance ministry whatever it is for you in your spirit, that you recognize just how blessed and incredible you are, that you recognize that the Creator has never ever given up despite what it looks like. And in those moments when you feel like you have no one here on earth to turn to, you remember to turn to God. His way is the right way. I hope you're blessed by this. This is Your Way Is Better. I feel like I've been climbing up the tallest mountain, and it seems to be impossible. I look back over my life and I see what I've accomplished. It's discouraging for me to stumble. Then You encourage me to stand. I never knew safety till I fell in Your hands. And I wanna thank You, Lord, for not allowing me to do it my way. From myself. Oh, and I found that Your way is better. 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 Your way is better.
Better, better, better. What's up, everybody? It is your boy, Anthony Ponder, and I am so excited to be here and to be a part of the Lincoln Park Musical Festival. Big shout out to the director, Anthony Smith, and all of his amazing staff for orchestrating such an amazing event. We just came by real quick just to give you a little bit of encouragement. I know we are in a crazy time right now. I don't have all the answers, but I think and I hope that we can encourage you real quick with these songs that God has given us. The only thing I can think of right now is the story of the children of Israel when they are in transition, leaving captivity into walking into the promised land. And there is a point of the story where the people of God are in front of the Red Sea, and the army is behind them, getting ready to capture them or kill them. And I am sure, just like many of us, they were scared. I'm sure at that point their faith was wavering, and that they were unsure of a lot of things. And I came by to tell you that that's okay. But I wanted to remind you what God told the people of God, and that was simply to stand still and see the salvation of God. So my encouragement today right now is just that you stand still and watch God work. So this first song that we're going to do is called The Process. The Process, again, talks about transition, just waiting for the promise of God and just not being sure, being insecure, sometimes being scared. And let's be honest, sometimes being frustrated. But there's a line in the song that I want you to remember, and hopefully you can keep this in your spirit, that says that it may not feel good, but it's for my good. So this song that we're going to do is called The Process. We hope you enjoy. We hope you're encouraged, and don't give up.
Before a mother can give birth, she must go through labor.
So we too must endure the process to fully become who is called you to be.
It's for your good.
It may not feel good, but it's working.
It's working.
It's working. But it's working.
your favor. Hey.
For the making of you.
Favor in my home, favor in my job.
No, the thing
concern is the timing of the Lord.
The timing of the Lord is best.
The timing of the Lord is best.
The timing of the Lord is best.
The timing of the Lord
is blessed.
That's why I
call you.
Say it again, yeah.
The timing of the Lord is best.
Hey.
The timing of the Lord is best. The timing of the Lord is best.
His promise is always.
His promise is always. Yes and amen. So I'll wait.
On you.
The timing of the Lord is best.
You know it's best for us.
The timing of the Lord is best.
Hey.
The timing of the Lord is
that's
best.
Why. Right where you are. Put your hands on it.
I know that you know.
Put your hands on it. The song just says, I know.
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
We're going to do Pastor Taylor. We're going to wait.
Listen.
We're going to wait on
him. Listen, we're going to wait. Huh? It may not feel good, but it's worth it,
While we wait,
we're going to thank God for salvation and glory, huh?
And glory. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what we going to do.
We got covered by house, holiness, See, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, Pastor. Let me tell you something, woman of God. Let me tell you something, soldiers of the cross. Tell you something. That was everything we needed. That was Corona covering. That was pandemic praise. Everything we needed.
That's just what it was. Yes, it was. I'm excited because even in the midst of nobody can stop our praise. They can't stop our worship. No matter what the enemy is trying to do, we done sent him back to the pits of hell from which he came. Because Lincoln Park Music Festival 14.2. Oh, my God.
Celebration of
talking
spirit.
About spiritual celebration.
This is what joy unspeakable looks like, huh? We may not get the sentence out all the way, but our hands are doing, huh? I promise you, we won't get undignified. I promise you.
Talking about faith. You want to see these glasses come off and the sweat start pouring and the shoes come off. You see how Patty, you know how Patty kicked them shoes off when she's singing.
Woo!
You know what I'm saying? You know how Patty get excited, Patty Bella. She just kick them off and just go for it.
I keep a church fan.
That's
right
how we feel right now, bro.
Just in case. Joy unspeakable.
Awesome.
Hallelujah, salvation and glory. Bless. Yes. Your way is better. That song always does something for my spirit, Shelly Lee. And her husband, Khalil, Jamez, Adias Folsom. Listen. And that favor, huh? That favor in the process. That favor through the process. Because sometimes favor is the process. Lord Jesus.
Favor in the process, and then we know that scripture that says all things work together. All things work together for the good for those who are called according to his. Listen, they just sang that song. It's working. Oh my God. Anthony Ponder. All of the artists have been so phenomenal. The anointing has come through these lives. Thank God for creating Vimeo, Zoom, teleconferences, because through that we have been able to connect. And 20 years ago, this wouldn't have been possible. But God said, my word will not come back void. So whatever ministry is supposed to be going forward,
is going to go forward on this gospel night. Somebody say yes, section in the hall.
Come on here, Pastor. Unity.
Listen, I'm telling you, they get ready to have a staff meeting in hell because this wasn't supposed to happen this way. It wasn't supposed to be people gathered in the side room and in the boardroom. And you still at work, huh? You're supposed to be gone already at the end of the day. But you're determined and purpose to be still and serve God from right there in the office of clergy affairs because.
Let me tell you something about the pandemic and worship. The truth is, when people were talking about churches being closed, I'm like, well, did they shut their bodies down? Because the truth of the matter is, I'm in my church right now, right? You know, like right here, okay? And wherever I am, whether it's the bathroom, whether it's the kitchen, when I just think, all I need is one memory and think back. Just listen, I don't even have to go that far back. I can think about just this morning, Pastor Taylor, that he let me know that I would be here this evening on this Vimeo recording, talking to people out there in Facebook land, Vimeo land, whatever land you in that you tuned in on, letting you know that God is good no matter what denomination, no matter what your faith, because God was God before Christianity, God was God before Islam, God was God, and God is all of our God, and we're going to worship and adore and give God praise no matter who, what, faith, church, masjid, wherever you are. We know that if you just love
God. I told you I dare you to move some furniture. They should look, the house of hell should have not let this do
it.
Better than Rogers and Herb, huh? Better than Rogers and Hammerstein, huh? Better than Lawler. They shouldn't have let this duo get together. Not lose.
Hold on.
Not lose.
Better than that, you know, kind of chicken soup you probably got on right now because of the rainy weather. Even in the liquid sunshine, God is good. And yes, it's a little rain out there, a little wet. But listen, tonight has just been magnificent.
Magnificent. It's been and we're such not an done honor yet.
To... Oh, we got and a
we're
whole,
not done
we got
yet.
A whole lot.
We got listen, a headline for your nerves. I remember. Reverend Kevin Etail has also been a TV producer at BET for almost 30 years. And I remember sitting at my desk when a cassette, came across that said The Sounds of Blackness.
Yes.
I was like, how bold, how brilliant, how powerful, how purposeful is that title? The Sounds of Blackness. And how huge that is. And I'm telling you, you're thinking, oh, what kind of elevate? And they came out with that first song, Be Optimistic, As Long As You Keep Your Head to the Sky. And when people thought that was just inspirational but not gospel, they went all the way to I Believe. I believe in the power. Every minute, every hour. And in between, I'm sorry she ain't doing this one. But I'm telling you, I got my first public shout at work. I ain't never shouted at work before until the pressure came on. I need to leave for the pressure.
Sir.
So, ladies and gentlemen, listen. What, she's anointed.
Ladies and gentlemen.
She's anointed.
Listening audience, we are
she's
in
talented.
For another awesome treat. But this one is going to be over the top. God has been moving us higher and higher and higher. And now we're reaching a higher height. Come on, Pastor Taylor. Come on. Come on, let's bring it in.
Miss Ann Nesby!
Nesby!
Woo!
Come on.
Yeah, yeah! Tell you, I live my life knowing all the roads ahead of me are filled with peace and love. Every step so heavenly, falling bounce right up. Oh, miracles and dreams realized for me through faith. Nothing seems impossible if you believe, and I believe. Never ever doubt. Well, woo. Well. Oh yes, I do. No, I'll get my help. Oh yes. Woo. Looking in the mirror, I can see my eyes are glowing. Living testimony that the Spirit's in me flowing. Whoa. No, I'll get my help. Oh, yes, I will. So good. So good to believe. Yes, I believe. So good. So good to believe. Yes, I believe. Do you? Do you?
Never say die. Say die. Say die. The blackness. Black keep it, keep on.
I want everybody to be optimistic.
Say die, keep on.
Ooh. Ooh. Yeah. Keep your head, yeah, yeah, yeah. Love. your hand, face toward the sky. Oh, 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 you gotta keep on looking, keep on looking now. Hey, 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 you gotta keep your hands. You can win, yes. Your
to the sky.
Pastor Taylor, we can
Reverend
win.
Roundtree.
We
can win. As long as
we keep our head to the sky, we can win. We got this new slogan in Newark, and it says Newark versus COVID. We gonna win, but it's up to us. It's up to us individually. We can do things together. And they say the African proverb, that if you have one pencil, you can break it with a bunch of pencils. We got to learn how to, in some things, be collective, and in some things, own our individuality.
Come on, Pastor. Listen, Ann Nesby just reminds me of all things gospel, all things woman, all things weighted, all things holy, all things anointed.
All things
that woman was singing that song, seated. She was seated.
All things universal, all things unified, all things with love, all things connected, all things with concern, ooh, all things with to be beautified, all things, oh my God, oh my God.
I want somebody to
get that. All things work together for the good. My God, what an awesome performance.
Ann Nesby.
What a night. We have been blessed from the beginning with our greetings
from the mayor. From the beginning, from Brother Ian Johnson.
We got to go all
the way to the top.
We got to go to the top. Let's go to Anthony. Let's go to God positioned him. The oil runs from the head. It comes on down. We thank God for the mayor and LaMonica and all these other folks that came along.
You think about the head, I think about leaving the best for last. So either way, we was going to get to Mayor Raz Baraka. That fire spitter, demon splitter, huh? Go get her.
You better come on here, somebody. Come on, somebody.
That's my mayor.
Listen,
I told Mayor Raz Baraka, I said I wasn't born in Newark, New Jersey, but I'm going to die here.
Listen. Once you in here, you in here, baby. Not everybody. Listen, we got people that's been here for 80 years, wasn't born here, but they know it all day and every day. They're interwoven into the fabric of the city. Do you know that under the leadership, wait a minute, under his leadership, we talking about feeding people during the pandemic? They were so concerned, this administration was so concerned about people coming out that over 2 million meals had been delivered to people's doorsteps. Under the mayor's leadership, delivered. They didn't have to come pick it up. Under the leadership of his brother chief, Amini Baraka. I mean, when you with a team, he had a team.
As long as you keep your head to the sky.
And he put people out there. We used to shop write cards. We have to learn. Many churches have been a blessing throughout this pandemic. I'm not going to start calling churches, y'all, because y'all know who you are. And don't worry about me calling your name.
If you were doing the work, you know you were doing the work. But exactly. To every church and doing the work, things. God bless you. God bless you.
Listen to this, Pastor Taylor. There's, I heard this pastor once say, people shouldn't do things to be seen, but everybody should be seen doing something. Everybody should be seen doing something. We're still in the midst of a pandemic.
But everybody should be seen doing something. Hello.
Doing something. We're still in the midst of this pandemic. We have things going on in government, politically. You know what time is coming up. Between wearing your mask and figuring out how you're going to tell the world that they got to vote, God sits high and looks low. Always have been a God of the oppressed.
Victory over this enemy.
Come on. Tell them. Tell them, Pastor Taylor.
We've been through storms. We've been in holes like this before, and we know the way out.
Yes, sir.
If you got to take day off to get your mother and your grandmother to the poll, if you got to sit down with somebody to help them understand that written ballot, do the work. Don't expect change if you won't change. Do the work.
That's right.
Vote victory over this enemy. Let's get it. Let's go. Let's go.
That's right.
And we're grateful that we have this man
Monday,
in
by the way.
To show this thing, because Newark's about to show the world. Newark's about to show the world, just like we showed the world in coming out of that lead. That see, everybody talked about the lead in the water.
You don't hear nothing going now.
Into it. They don't say nothing now that we're out of it. 18 months
earlier.
We
almost finished 18 months.
But listen. That ain't what we came for. We came to edify the Lord, glorify the Lord, thank God for the Lord, thank God for Ann Nesby. Thank God for Anthony Ponder and missions, Ministries Desire. Thank God for Seychelles Elise. Thank God for Pastor Dale Cicero and the Psalms of Praise. We thank God. I thank God for the Sounds of the New Ark under the brilliant direction of Reverend Cheryl Bragg. I thank God for Brother Charles Jerkins. Thank God for Brother Carl Bristol. Look at me flowing from the top.
Right.
I thank God for Brother A. Natural. I thank God for Brother Lenny Harrell. I thank God. Thank God for Brother Ian Johnson. And I thank God for the titan that is Dionne Warwick, reminding us that what the world needs now is love, sweet love. And I thank that Queen Susu Bobian for singing short-footed in her own apartment like she was in a tabernacle. And because she sang like that, she was.
Yes.
I thank God for the neighbors that was in their sleep slumbering and crying about how good God was. So, Pastor, I want to thank you for the ways that you have been just a support to this city, to all of the houses of faith. I thank you for the ways that you consistently and ferociously lift up every church, no matter how tiny or magnanimous. You are there on fire with fire. And I thank God for you.